the hole, then I ran it. Get money, let's go. You ain't trying to get that second flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha cha macha with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, ducking 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me feel myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah. I got top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up. Did it? Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the wheels suspended. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. Hey, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was top, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I gold it again and again. Who was the dummy to doubt? I'm the coldest around, but he folding again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan.
First opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers. Three quarters of the NFL season are complete. What lurks in our final month? We're underway in Week 14.
Fielded in the end zone.
Ultimately get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
First and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
First and 10 at their 25-yard line. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Christian Jones, the one who picked it. And he will score. Defense looking like they have come to play. The pick six, and just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visits. What do we hear during these drills? Pass. Ball's in the air.
And then my favorite.
Oski. That's the interception. That means everybody find someone to block. Block them legally. Stay on your feet. And they get it done. Touchdown.
And it's good. And they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead.
14. Packers nothing. Matt Prater to kick off for Detroit.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this going around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. They'll get four on second down, but it leaves them with third and still nine to go.
A gain of four.
In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that, because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over-game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
Call that a 41-yard punt, 6 yards on the return, and the Lions will take over.
At their own 35-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop the this offense.
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45.
Kerryon Johnson, the
typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Heavy set out there on third and one. They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Not at all what they envisioned on third down, 3 yards in the wrong direction.
For the Lions.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. It's a 42-yard punt. They keep him to just a yard on the return. And the Packer drive will start from deep in their own territory with a first and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. This is their third drive right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
On second and 9, Rodgers. That'll be complete to Alan Lazard. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. 25 yards there on the catch and run. Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle, feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. Eluding the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. What can't Aaron Rodgers do? The legwork there getting him the first.
I'm not sure he falls under the category of mobile quarterback, but he's athletic enough that if you don't keep your rush lanes intact, he finds a way to hurt you.
As coaches like to say, I wouldn't call him a burner, but enough there in the tank. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 38. That's thrown quickly out wide to Lazard. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
A gain of 9 brings up second and 1 at the 29-yard line.
The give is to Jones. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one.
Adams hauling it in from Rodgers. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Packers are back within a score. On is Mason Crosby for the point after. And that one makes it 14-7.
Makes the score Lions 14, Packers 7.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. Taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches.
Through one quarter, 14-7, our score.
Lions 14, Packers 7.
Options galore here, second and a few inches.
A shotgun snap for Stafford. Looking for Adam Dolan, it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown.
Saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Now Crosby for the point after. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14.
That ties the game at 14.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Fielded in the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The Lions take over first and 10.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And that 14-0 lead to begin the ball game, well, that's gone now. Time to regroup.
I think even up two touchdowns, they knew this one would be a walk in the park. And I think that's why we would see the head coach going up and down the sidelines telling his team, let's stay with it, let's keep going. It's almost like he knew they were going to make their run at him, and they have. As you said, let's see if they can regroup and get going again.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Flush to his right. Throwing deep for Galladay. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
Incomplete.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. From the gun, here's Stafford.
You never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Packers will have a short field to work with here as they take over first and 10. Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. A give to Jones. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. The big nose tackle, Danny Shelton, there to swallow him up.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Jones. He takes this for about six down inside the 40.
To Aaron Jones.
Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
A good chance. This is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a third and three. Now it's Rodgers. Steps away to his left.
Now that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a three and out there and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
Yeah.
Now a first down carry by Jones. Down to the 25. Trey Flowers there on the tackle.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range, but boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
They begin the drive with Johnson. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
And incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
It's now 3rd down and 9 yards to go.
After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Out of the gun, Stafford. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. Here's Jack Fox now as he's on to punt for Detroit. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Not good at all. Punt of just 24 yards there. And it'll be Packer football here. 1st down and 10.
At their own 36-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And 2 interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. And not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11. After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11. To throw, it's Rodgers. And Walker has it. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
Kate Walker complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
A gain of 11.
11 yards and a Green Bay Packer first down. 2nd quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Devontae Adams with touchdown number 15 of the year and 2nd of the game. And the Packers have taken the lead. Extra point try now for Crosby. Oh, he missed the PAT. No good on the extra point, so a letdown there. And this will stay a 6-point ball game.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
Rams take over first and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up.
And get this man complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Stafford going to give this one off to Johnson. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays.
Well, there's zero doubt that the Detroit Lions like Kerryon Johnson's ability, but he's been dinged up a little bit in his first 2 years in the NFL, so they went out and used a day two pick this past year on DeAndre Swift, the rookie running back from Georgia. I think to pair them together and maybe send a message. But I think if Kerryon Johnson can stay on the field, he could be an awfully productive back in the NFL.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. To throw again, Stafford. They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 15 yards on the play, first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Flushed out right. Incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second down and 10.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again. Stafford. Open there. He's got him. The tight end, Hockenson. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A good pickup there, 22. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Again, it's Stafford. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Looking for Hockenson, and he's got him. Touchdown, Detroit. T.J. Hockenson, his third touchdown now on the year. Have tied it. If they hit the extra point, they'll have the lead. Crater on and the extra point. And with that, his guys take the lead here by a point. Sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Under a minute to play here in the half. Time for a late drive.
It makes sense when you think about it. Hey, try and get a field goal, give yourself a lead going into the half. But if you're going to do this, you better have supreme trust in your quarterback. Supreme trust in the guy who's going to handle the football. Because if you turn it over here, not only do you go in down at the half, you've given the momentum squarely to your opponent.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Rodgers. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 35. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
The Lions take over first and 10 at the 26-yard line.
After the interception, here's Stafford. Oh, a hit. He lost the football. Stafford puts it on the ground, and the Packers pick it up. He's at the 40. Past the 20. 10. And he will bring this one back. A fumble return for the Green Bay touchdown. The offenses have success. You could say they've run wild a little bit. Time for the defenses to get into the act, and one does here.
Nothing like a little bit of revenge for the defense. They've had to deal with it all game long. Both offenses going up and down the field. How about it when they take the ball away and take it to the other end zone?
And that'll make this a six-point game.
Makes the score Packers 27, Lions 21.
So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Ready to get their next drive underway. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Again, it's Jones. He'll have a first down past the 40. The 40. He's at the 30. Tim.
What's up?
Touchdown, Packers.
Aaron Jones.
With touchdown number 20 on the year. And the Packers add on to their lead. They blitzed defensively there, but he was able to slip through that first layer, and then he was gone.
I think they won the leverage game, didn't they?
Yes.
Right? They saw the blitz coming. That got to him a little bit, but they leveraged it perfectly and found not just a crease, a gigantic hole. And off he goes, and he's still going all the way to the end zone.
Now Crosby for the point after. And the lead is now 13.
Makes the score Packers 34, Lions 21.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
taken in the end zone. And he returns this to the 22.
Danny Amendola on the return. The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. From the gun, here's Swift. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
Got a man, it's Amendola. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Give him 6 yards in the first down. First and line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. To throw is Stafford. Looking downfield for Jones. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing again. Stafford. Goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
And now offensively it's third and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half. Escaping the pressure right. Looking deep now for Amendola. And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down. Here comes the Lions punter now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Also a nice return of 12 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. They'll go again to Jones. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
And Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
It's a gain of 8.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
50-yard line.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. Here's Jones. And he stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down.
I haven't met a defense coordinator yet that thinks second and 2 is a fun situation to try and defend. Playbook is wide open for an offense, partner.
Nice job. Hold him to 1 after that 8-yard pickup on first down. For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. down to the 48. Enough for the first. Only a yard there on the keeper, but that's all he needed. First down.
So that was all you're looking for on a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I've got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up, and let's keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
A nice run there by Jones on first down as he'll wind up getting about five, so second and five coming up.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Jones, and a pretty good run as he'll get this down close to a first at the Lions 38. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
So many times someone's success is the product of a lot of things coming together really well. And for Aaron Jones in 2019, it all came together for him. He stayed healthy, was on the field for all 16 games, got handed the ball 100 more times last year, and as an end result, broke 1,000 yards in a season rushing for the first time in his career.
This has been a good march down the field, but now they're stuck looking at a second and 14. Jones, they're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. Third and 17 following the two negative plays. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Just a yard on the run there. That's going to bring us to a fourth down.
Really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4. Those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
60-yard attempt.
And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort, but it's well short. And this score will stay right where it is.
Now, Charles, all things considered, I guess that's not a critical miss at this stage, is it?
No, but still everything helps when you're trying to finish off a ball game. And you're right, not critical in terms of the scoreboard and the team, but the guy with the golden foot, he knows he's only as good as his last kick.
A very solid gain of 27.
First and 10 at the 23-yard line.
Now a first down throw, Stafford. Eluding the crowd, and he takes this one in for the Lions touchdown. DeAndre Swift, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions able to get this back within a touchdown. And the lead will shrink to six.
Makes the score, Packers 34, Lions 28.
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. And look at this, they come right back with a big shot downfield. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. A big play there, Rodgers to Adams, 47 yards. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Now Jones.
just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it. And the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down. Well, if you're going to turn things around in a game like this, Charles, those are the kind of plays that you need.
And I just love the way that defense rallied to the football on that one. They got the completion, but he was smothered behind the line of scrimmage. And when you make tackles like that, your whole defense is going to be fired up. Really nice play getting to the ball.
A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
First down.
Big hook up there. Forced to throw it on third down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. Your clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. But now it'll be third down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He'll get this to Lazard. And he'll get inside the 10, but he's short of the line he needed. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
A 26-yard attempt.
And the 13-year man puts it through, and that will make this a 9-point lead. A big one there. That gives him a little cushion and makes it a 2-score game.
Yeah, bled a little time off the clock, put some points on the board. It's not totally out of reach yet, but it has to feel pretty good to them right now because as a defender, you go out on the field and say, guess what? You can put some points on the board, but that won't beat us.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a 2-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. Danny Amendola, that was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Boy, the numbers throwing the football just not trending in the right direction. Last week he was under 50%. He's under 50% again here.
And we haven't gotten an announcement, but it appears to me that he might be a little dinged up and is just trying to play through. He was one of those tough guys that wants to answer the bell each and every play for his team. That might be throwing off his accuracy.
And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete. The Lions on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
He's going to let this go deep for Allison. It's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The Lions turned away on fourth down. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. Jones. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. A quick throw there out to Jeffrey.
And that's when it's fun to play defense. When you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football and spill the play, that's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
Well, this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Aaron Jones, his 21st touchdown of the season. And the Packers add 6 to their lead. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Extra point try now for Crosby. And that one could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead.
Score, Packers 44, Lions 28.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 11 yards there, first down. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10.
36-yard
operating from the gun. Stafford, that's caught by Geronimo Allison. They got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 23 yards, the final tally. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. On 2nd and 10, Stafford. Flush to his right. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Jair. He's going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch counterpunch, hasn't it? All throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
Brings up 2nd and 11 at the 19-yard line.
A 2nd and 11 from the 19. Now the toss to Jones, running right. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. The Lions now going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds left to go in the game. That's out to the left and complete. And he is going to get the first down as he covers up after a pretty good shot there.
A 5-yard gain.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right? Just us against the world and get it done. How happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one.
Score.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did.